Hello my dear students, welcome back. Today I am here with the third part of the chapter Rotation and Revolution. Hope all of you have seen the first and second part of this chapter. You have liked and understood. Yes, I have received so many of your valuable feedback which really motivates me. In the first part and second part I have talked about rotation and its effect. Today we will learn more information about this chapter which will really helpful and students keep learning, be focused. So let's start. In the first part and second part I have talked that earth is having two type of motion. One is rotation, already we have got to know about that, and today we will get to know about another that motion, that is revolution. So student, we have to know what is revolution. Revolution means when earth that revolve or moves around the sun. When earth revolves or moves around the sun, in which way? Along its elliptical orbit. So here students, you are getting to see here a new term I have written. So what is elliptical orbit? It is not the circular way or the not circular that orbit through that the earth is revolving around the sun. It is having a special characteristic. It is just like that. It means in the center of this orbit sun is there and the earth is revolving around this sun, and through that you are getting to see the distance between sun and earth is not same everywhere. Okay, it is varying. This kind of that orbit is known as elliptical orbit. And you have to remember, whenever it is revolving, the direction of revolution, it will be the same of like rotation. Means west to east. Is it clear, students? So how the earth is revolving around the sun? Now, one more important thing you have to remember. Here, are you getting to see the arrows? These arrows, it is showing the imaginary axis or the inclination of earth axis. It will always be same. The angle, it always be same. And the direction of north pole and south pole, it will also be same everywhere throughout the world. Is it clear? Throughout the this solar, that it means this orbit, elliptical orbit. Is it clear, student? Now, one more information about the revolution, that how much time it takes to revolve around the sun. Earth takes 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes, then 45 seconds. Which actually this 5 hour, 48 minutes, 45 seconds, we take as a round of figure of 6 hours. Means 365 days, 6 hours. This is the time which when earth revolves around the sun, it takes to complete this revolution within this 365 days, 6 hours. This 6 hours, it is the 1/4 of a day. Because you know, one day means 24 hours, so 6 hours means 1/4 daytime. Is it clear, student? Now, every year, this 365 days, we take or we mention as a year, 1 year. So, where this 1/4 day will go? Okay? So, this 1/4 day, every 4 years after, this also added and form one full day. Means 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4. It will be that full one day. Okay. and finally this is 24 hours it is. And where this wand is going? It is adding after 4 years in the month of February last, you will get to see in the calendar when the date of February month, it will become 28 to 129 days. That is the leap year, okay? Or the total day of a year, when it will be 365 plus 1 is equal to 366 days, that year known as the leap year. Is it clear, student? This is known as leap year. So in the exam it can ask the question, what is leap year? So you have to give the example with the help of revolution, that when earth revolves around the sun, it takes 365 days 6 hours, and these 6 hours after every 4 years is add and form a single day, which also added there in the month of February of this year, and it is known as leap year. Is it clear? Now how you will get to know which year is leap year? In that case, you have to always see that if any of the year will be divided by 4 or 400, then the year will be leap year. How? This is 2020. We can divide it 5, then is it clear that, so this is also we can get to see this 2028 leap year. Same way we can say 2008 2012 2016 2020 2024, which year will be, even 2000 also, which year will be divided by 4 and 400, this year will be known as leap year. Okay, revolution speed, that we have to also know. Here the speed of revolution is 107,000 kilometer per hour. It is approximately 30 kilometer per second. Okay, and here you have to remember, when the earth is coming closer to that sun, then the speed little more increasing. When the earth is going far from sun, the speed little more decreasing due to that gravitational force. Okay students, now students, we have to know about the effects of revolution. Yes, I'm writing here effects of revolution. So there are so many effects are there of revolution. One by one we will get to know. First is there aphelion and perihelion. So what is aphelion and perihelion? See properly, this is the elliptical orbit of earth. Sun is there. I already have said the distance between earth and sun is not equal. So here perihelion. Why the distance between here, if we compare between these two, here the distance is less than this part. When it is coming? On 3rd January. And the distance will be here 147 million kilometer. Why it is the name given perihelion? Because peri means close, helion means sun. So when earth will be close to sun, that is known as perihelion. Okay, another also on the other hand, you are getting to see the distance between sun and earth is more compared to that. So this condition, it is also coming in a year when the earth is also revolving around the sun. On which date? 4th July. This date also known as aphelion, and the distance will be 152 million kilometer. Okay, so here students, you are seeing the when earth is far distance, that is known as aphelion. When earth will be close, that is known as perihelion. But here aphelion, the term, it has come from afe, means away, and then helion means sun. When earth will be far from sun, that is known as aphelion. So on 3rd January, that is perihelion. On 4th July, that is aphelion. 3rd January, the distance will be 147 million kilometer, and on 4th July, on aphelion, the distance will be 152 million kilometer. Now the question sometimes asks, what is the average distance between earth and sun? So the average distance, between earth and sun is 149 million kilometer. Is it clear, students? So what is aphelion and what is perihelion? Another effects of revolution, that is season formation of seasons. Here, how the season forming? When the sun also at the center and earth is revolving, the inclination angle always be same, it is not changing. So different parts of the world is getting different amount of heat. Okay, due to that the season are forming. In that case, we will get to see when in the northern hemisphere there is summer. So on other hand, the southern hemisphere, it will be winter. And again, after 6 months, what will happen due to the apparent movement of the sun? When northern hemisphere, it will be winter, then summer. That southern hemisphere, it will be summer. Just opposite means after 6 months, gradually the sun is coming closer to earth and going far from these. Due to that, the season is forming, because the different parts of the world is getting different amount of heat. Okay students, so it is the another also, we can say, the effect of the revolution. So students, and you have seen different information about revolution. What is revolution, its speed, as well as the two main that effects of revolution. Hope you have understood that. So be with me to see and to know about more information about different effects of revolution in the next part. So stay safe, stay blessed. Thank you.